Welcome to HINS 2018, and I'm here talking with Sonia Breeze. And Sonia is a partner at Deloitte in New Zealand, based in Auckland. Sonia's given a paper on change management in the digital world at pace. And she was talking about managing change, lessons learned, tools, techniques, and so on. So Sonia, can you give us some highlights?
There is an approach that you can take to change that means that you're much more likely to get the adoption of the technology, which is really important, because what we see is there's lots of initiatives out there that don't actually stick because people aren't adopting it and people aren't involved enough and stuff like that. So there is a bit of a recipe, and I talked through some of those things. It's really understanding that change is a behavioural science, so we really look to see how we can change the way that people think and act and feel. And one of the best ways of doing that is having them really closely involved in the technology early on, in the design of it, getting, you know, handling it, having input on how, you know, it gets put together, because that way they internalise the change and they're a lot more likely to first of all design something that's going to be fit for purpose, but also to feel good about what's in it for them and for their patients. Yeah.
Now this, of course, you're talking about the health sector now, here, whatever, but do the lessons learned and a lot of the principles go across the board in various sectors, and have you had experience in others that maybe adopt change better than health, or not as quickly as health, or?
Actually, culture change, it is, the way that you go about it is the same no matter what the organisation or the sector, but what you find is that there are some key things that you can do to accelerate the change, and those things tend to be different for different organisations. So for some organisations, it's things like how they celebrate successes, and what they celebrate as a success has a big impact on the culture. For others, it's things like jumping through hoops to get decisions made, which ends up with quite a, you know, bureaucratic and stifles innovation. So there are things that you can do around processes and practices, and the approach is the same across all organisations, but normally there are particular things that are very symbolic within a given organisation that you can change that are going to have a bigger impact. Yeah.
One of the other speakers was talking about saying clinicians are the most complex customers, and this is one of the people who's a CIO overseas, and the clinicians were the most complex customers that he had to deal with. So have you had some experience and lessons learned in dealing with, say, as a cohort of people to deal with and adapting to digital transformation in health, the clinicians as a group, and it's not to cast aspersions, just to say they really are a very important, a pivotal part of the change.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, like everything else, there's a spectrum. There's some very early adopters that are completely innovating and leading the pack, and there are others that, you know, think perhaps they'll retire before it will really affect them. So I don't think clinicians are any different than anywhere else. What I do see, though, is that we can have a reluctance to involve clinicians early on because we think that they're not going to, you know, like something that's not completely ready, so we keep trying to finesse them and get them more perfect. But really the trick is to get the clinicians on board early on and know that no one's got the answer yet, we're just working through it together. And they have fantastic ideas, and I find that they're really quick to come up with them. They're very intuitive. So, yeah, I think the earlier we involve them, the better it always works out.
And do you look for champions?
Yep, and those champions sometimes might be those leading edge innovators, and sometimes they might be those that are the complete naysayers, because they're going to have a big impact. You know, if people see that you can get them, you know, feeling good about the change, then that has a big impact on others as well. So, yes, we definitely use champions, but you just, you know, you never know who it's going to be. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So some of the ones who have started as the naysayers and end up being converted can be the very best ones.
Absolutely. Right. And they can be the people that have quite a good attention for detail. So they can actually help you iron out a lot of crinkles along the way. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And what about on the patient, the consumer side, in terms of change? What are the sort of the key aspects of dealing with the patient groups?
Yeah, and of course, anything we design with technology, we've got to have the patient at the centre. And one of the things that we demonstrated today was Deloitte Assist, which is basically where patients, instead of just ringing a bell for a nurse and the nurse comes and then sees what they want and go back and try and work out the right person to deal with it, they just speak into it and depending on what they want, it routes their request to the right person. So for medication, it might be a nurse. For, you know, a hot drink, it might be a patient care assistant. So, you know, that's a great example of how things can really be improved for patients with technology that's very readily available now. So we're just in the process of looking at that, implementing that for one of the New Zealand DHBs.
So this is the patient in a hospital ward.
In a hospital ward.
Who can then say then what it is.
Yeah. And they get responded to much more quickly. And then also the data sits in the background. So then you can use that information to better schedule and roster the type of staff you need at a given time and given day. And
so that's picking up on some of the commercial things. If you ring the BNZ, for example, or you ring them, they'll say, what is the nature of your request?
Yes.
You know, and often if you're really specific, you'll find
press a button and and it actually takes it one step further because it's all voice. It's no buttons. Yeah.
There's no buttons.
So this hasn't been implemented yet?
It has been implemented. We've implemented it in Australia and we're in the process of implementing it. And it's not a long implementation, you know, 6 weeks. We can get it in. So, it's really great to be
That's doing great. That's a really good one. Sonia, thank you so much for your time and welcome and enjoy the rest of the conference.
Thank you.
I appreciate having you here. And as I said, your presentation and slides are going to be available on the HINS website for delegates and others to have a look at.